In the short story, The Black Cat by Edgar Allan Poe, the literary elements elevate the story to make it compelling and interesting. In the short story, The Black Cat by Edgar Allan Poe, conflict, character versus self slash alcohol, boosts the story's plot. From this quote from the conflict, we see the narrator has a problem with an addiction to alcohol. Hung it with the tears streaming from my eyes, and with the bitterest remorse in my heart, hung it because I knew it had loved me, and because I had felt it had given me no reason of offense, we see that the narrator has a hard time letting the cat go. And as he is getting rid of it, his emotions are spiraling, and he starts crying because he believes the cat has done none wrong unto him, even though it has caused him so much pain. Conflict in The Black Cat can be compared to the conflict in the Netflix show Stranger Things with the character Billy and the conflict he deals with himself.
Yeah, I'm a little bit busy in here, Susan.
Open the door right now!
What's wrong?
Why don't you tell us?
Because I don't know.
We can't find Maxine.
And her window's open. Where is she?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Look, I'm sure she just, I don't know, went to the arcade or something. I'm sure she's fine.
You were supposed to watch her.
I know, Dad, I was. It's just you guys were 3 hours late and, oh, I have a date. I'm sorry, okay?
So that's why you've been staring at yourself in the mirror like some faggot instead of watching your sister.
I have been looking after her all week, Dad. Okay, she wants to run off, then that's her problem, all right? She's 13 years old. She shouldn't need a full-time babysitter. And she's not my sister.
What did we talk about? What did we talk about?
Respect and responsibility.
That is right. Now, apologize to Susan.
I'm sorry, Susan.
It's okay, Neil, really.
No, it's not okay. Nothing about his behavior is okay. But he's gonna make up for it. He's gonna call whatever whore he's seeing tonight and cancel their date. And then he's gonna go find his sister. Like the good, kind, respecting brother that he is. Isn't that right, Billy?
Isn't that right?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry I couldn't hear you.
Yes, sir.
Find Max.
As we see Billy, we grow to see that he is rude and unnecessarily mean to almost everyone around him, including his sister.
What a surprise. I thought I told you to stay away from him, Max.
Billy, go away.
You disobeyed me. And you know what happens when you disobey me.
Billy.
I break things.
At first, this is caused by almost a whole lifetime of mental and physical abuse from his father and his mother's death when Billy was young. But later, this anger and destruction is caused by a possession from the Mind Flayer, a super intelligent, man-shaped creature with four tentacles by its mouth which it uses to strike its prey, and it no longer comes to choice. At the end, we see Billy's human side come out against the Mind Flayer, and it helps him to save Eleven, and is unlike Black Cat, because as far as we know, there is no redemption for our narrator, though there is for Billy.
This is your new sister.
You told her the wave was 7 feet. You ran to her on the beach. dress with a blue and red flower. Yellow sandals covered in sand. She was pretty.
These two stories are alike in the sense at first, because they both had a control, though minor maybe, over their addiction slash anger, but at the end it seemed to become less of a choice for the narrator, and definitely was not a choice for Billy, as they sunk deeper into their habits. These stories make the reader feel sympathy for Billy because of the abuse he faces, and for me, at least, some sympathy at the beginning for the narrator, because he is in so much pain from his addiction, even though that sympathy ceases at the end. This type of conflict can also be found in No Good Nick, another show from Netflix. Nick, instead of eternal conflict like Billy, her black cat, is her dad.
No, Nick, they're the bad guys. You were just righting a wrong.
No Good Nick is about a girl who had a good life with her father, running their family business, an Italian restaurant, Franzelli's, until the Thompsons, who were running a fancier Italian restaurant across the street, sabotaged Franzelli's customers and their online presence to get more customers and money than Franzelli's.
Welcome to Franzelli's!
This causes Nick and her dad to lose money, and Nick's dad ends up stealing money to lift his business up again, and he gets caught and sent to jail. After this, Nick makes it her goal to steal from and get revenge on the Thompsons by pretending she is an orphan and the Thompsons' distant relative. Along the way, Nick grows attached to the Thompsons and doesn't believe that it's right to keep deceiving them.
No, Nick, they're the bad guys. You were just righting a wrong. You're the good guy in this story.
How? How am I a good guy? I betrayed them. I lied to them. I tore them apart. I feel like a monster.
You did what you had to do. And I'm proud of you. Nick, this is everything we've dreamed of. And the only one left is Ed.
But I don't want to do it anymore. I don't want to hurt Ed. Please.
No. You can't stop now. Ed is the most guilty of all of them. If he'd have given us an extension on that loan, we wouldn't be in this situation. No, you have to finish what you started. You have to do this for me. For our family.
B Though Nick's black cat is external, it is similar to the narrator's situation. Nick's dad is the only family she has left, and she feels attached to him, so it prevents her from cutting him out of her life. This is comparable to how the narrator of the black cat finds himself unable to hurt or destroy the new black cat in his life because of the cruelty towards Pluto, his first cat. Another way they are similar is a situation both characters are forced into by their black cats, as Nick is forced into stealing and deceiving the Thompsons by her father, even though she tells him repeatedly through the end that she wants to stop. Our narrator in the story does try to stop his addiction, but the cat comes back to haunt him, ending him up in deep, deep trouble. The mood of both of these is similar because at the beginning, in both their stories, they give off a happy vibe, and nothing really seems to be going wrong, but the mood changes at the end of their stories as they get deeper into their lie or addiction. As well as the conflict, mood and tone are crucial literary elements to the story. One night, returning home, much intoxicated from one of my haunts about town, I fancied that the cat avoided my presence. I seized him when, in his fright at my violence, he inflicted a slight wound upon my hand with his teeth. The fury of a demon instantly possessed me. I knew myself no longer. My original soul seemed at once to take its flight from my body, and more than fiendish malevolence, gin-nurtured, reared every fiber of my frame. I took from my waistcoat pocket a penknife, opened it, grasped the poor beast by its throat, and deliberately cut one of its eyes from the socket. The atmosphere this quote creates from the black cat is a crazed movie. When the narrator describes himself as being out of control of his actions and his soul, it gives the reader the feeling that his alcohol addiction is very extreme, and it shows that it really is out of control because he knows the cat did nothing wrong to him. In The Black Cat by Edgar Allan Poe, literary elements such as conflict and mood and tone boost the plot and make it more interesting. Thank you for watching. What other shows or books do you think are similar to the conflict or the mood and tone of The Black Cat?